A user manual from Samsung's Russia website confirms the existence of Galaxy A3, Galaxy A5 and Galaxy A7 2017 models. Geekbench result shows up for Qualcomm's upcoming Snapdragon 835 chipset. Android 7.0 Nougat update started to roll out for Moto G4 Plus from India. Samsung Galaxy S8 may feature the S Pen from the Galaxy Note series lineup. Hi, this is Cheyenne. It's Friday and you are watching Insider Expert. While Samsung has already confirmed that the Galaxy A series 2017 is coming soon, but the company is yet to confirm that which smartphones will be included in this series. As we already know that the series will be comprised of Galaxy A3, Galaxy A5 and Galaxy A7. A user manual from Samsung's Russia website confirms that the existence of these handsets. Not only this, but it also revealed some important features. All the devices will be IP68 certified, meaning that the devices will be dust and water resistant. All the handsets will be NFC enabled and support for Samsung Pay. Not only this, but the fingerprint sensor will be embedded right into the home button, meaning that the Samsung Galaxy A3 will be the most affordable smartphone from the company bearing a fingerprint scanner. Not only this, the handsets will come with Android 6.0 at the time of launch, but later they will be upgraded to be the newest version of Android. Qualcomm's upcoming Snapdragon 835 processor will be the one that will be powering most of the flagship high-end smartphones throughout 2017. Now, a latest piece of information just arrived to us before Qualcomm gives a longer introduction to its newest processor at CES 2017. The Geekbench result shows that the processor has been run on a smartphone dubbed as FIH-PM1. The octa-core CPU is clocked at 1.9 GHz and it comes with 4 GB of RAM pre-installed running Android 7.0 Nougat. The single core results for the processor is 1844 points, while the multi-core result scores at 5426 points. And it's not very much impressive, as the previous year Snapdragon 821 processor running on a OnePlus 3T falls a little below this score. While it may be assumed that the phone on which the processor has been tested is somehow performance restricted, and when the final results come, it will may impress us. So we have to wait till 2017 to see how exactly the newest high-end processor actually performs. Android 7.0 Nougat update started to roll out for Motorola Moto G4 Plus. The update started in India, actually will be sent in waves, which means that it may take a couple of weeks to actually reach your handset. The newest update features an improved doze mode, which means that it will wait for your device to be inactive and then it will kill all the running background apps to improve your battery life and standby time. The most anticipated feature of this update is the support for Unicode 9 emoji, and it will also bring multi-window support to Moto G4 Plus devices. And in case if you are a little bit impatient, you can manually download the update by heading over to your settings, then about phone, and finally software update. And on a side note, be sure to charge your phone to the fullest. Samsung Galaxy S8 may finally embrace with a feature of the company's very own Note lineup. While the plans are very sketchy at the moment, but there are possibilities that Galaxy S8 may come with an additional S Pen accessory, which means that the display size of the phone will be around 6 inches or higher. There are also certain possibilities that Samsung may officially close their Note lineup and coming up with only one flagship per year, which also will address certain issues to those S Pen users who are looking for a replacement of their Galaxy Note 7. Apart from this, there are also certain rumors that Galaxy S8 may come with very less to almost no bezels. Samsung will officially ditch those physical buttons instead of soft keys with 3D touch features enabled on it. Samsung Galaxy S7 Edge was the best designed smartphone of 2016, and if these rumors are to be taken as true, then we might be looking to a device that will set new benchmarks in design and possibilities in future. Now that brings us to the question of the day, that what do you guys think? Apple should ditch the Note 7 lineup and come up with only one flagship per year, combining the features of both the Galaxy series and the Note series, or not? Now in my opinion, Samsung should not do this, as there are certain customers who didn't like smartphones with bigger displays, as they are not difficult to carry, but they also have difficulties in one-handed usage. And don't forget to write your opinion in the comment section below. And if you have liked my video, please give a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, then please subscribe to watch more awesome videos like this. Till then, bye.